Hey, what's going on? John Slenmez here, and I am continuing in the series of how to start an online business. If you have not joined me from the beginning of the journey of what is an online business or the online business basics, make sure that you click here in the card to get the first video and to go through the rest of the videos in the series. I think this is like video 9 or 10 in the series. I'm not sure how many exactly videos there will be in the series, but you can also click in the description below and you can go through everything that we've talked about so far, from business myths to how to make money in an online business and the kind of online businesses that you can create. But in this video, we're going to be talking about the importance of an email list. So this is one of those things that I think a lot of people that have not actually run an online business, and in fact, even a lot of people who do run online businesses, don't realize how important this is. And they can be a lot more successful if they have an email list and understand the importance of an email list. So I'm going to explain what an email list is in a second here. But I would also say that a lot of YouTubers, right? Again, I like to pick on YouTubers that, because I see it so many times as I talk to YouTubers that have huge channels and they have no email list and they're not selling any products and they're just making money off of ads and they consider themselves creators instead of business owners, and it's so sad because they could be making 10 times what they're making, literally 10 times what they're making easily, if they would create an email list. Okay, so let's talk about what an email list is. An email list is just simply a list of emails, and you get emails, we've talked about in some of the earlier videos in this series, by asking people for them, usually by offering what in internet marketing terms is called a lead magnet. My favorite of getting someone's email list is to offer them an actual email course as the lead magnet to say, click here and sign up and I will send you, my 5-day free course on X, and it's delivered over email. And the reason why I like to do that is because it's getting them used to opening up emails from me. It gets their email. It makes sense that they need to give their email in order to get an email course, okay? And I'm giving them value right up front in their inbox, and it's being dripped out. So they're not just getting some PDF that they download and never read. I can give them small bite-sized chunks, and they can go through that. But the point is that you need to build up this email list, because the email list is really the biggest asset of your business. If you were to take my business, Simple Programmer, okay, and you're to burn down everything from my website, articles, everything, and you just left me with the email list, I could rebuild it in a year, because the email list is really the most important aspect of the business. Now, granted, the website and getting the SEO and everything is great, but the real way that I make money with the Simple Programmer business is through the email list. And there's a ton of money that can be made through the emails, from selling affiliate offers, even doing advertising, and selling, of course, your own products. So email list is extremely, extremely important. Okay, I said I use a software, it's called Drip. You can check out, I'll have a referral link here that's my affiliate link, if you wanna sign up for Drip. I think that's the best email marketing software that exists today, okay? But you gotta have some way to collect the emails. So let's talk about kind of the basics here. Okay, so we talked about already that you're gonna have some kind of a lead magnet. So if you've got a blog, it's pretty simple. You wanna use a pop-up, okay? Now, a lot of people complain about pop-ups, and they say, I would never sign up on a pop-up, it's annoying, whatever. All the tests have been done, I've tested it myself, thousands of people have tested it. Pop-ups perform better than anything else for collecting email addresses, and so it's worth it. So you gotta do it, I don't like pop-ups, but it doesn't fucking matter what I like, it matters what makes sense for business, okay? If you've got a YouTube channel or a podcast, you're gonna have to figure out some other way, right? So you can put a link in the description for an email course. I've got one probably in this video, or I have them in a lot of my videos, okay? You could just point somewhere and say, click the card and sign up, okay? You can give them the address, you can do that on a podcast, you can say where they can sign up. You gotta give them a compelling enough offer, right? It's harder when you're on a different medium, but you can definitely find a way to get someone to sign up if you offer them something to sign up by email, okay? And I have to tell you that, going on a little bit of a side tangent here, email is really important. It's not the same as having subscribers on YouTube. It's not the same thing as having followers on Instagram. I mean, maybe the Instagram followers are reactive as well, but email is like in someone's inbox. It's the best way to sell, okay? Nothing I've ever seen so far has beat having email. Okay, even if you have a YouTube channel, I've got 150,000 subscribers on this YouTube channel at the time of making this video. And if I make a video, okay, maybe 2,000 or 3,000 views are on the video. Now I make 2 a day. If I did 1 a week, it'd probably be a higher view count, maybe be 10,000. But my point is that an average video is only going to get seen by a small percentage, and how many of those people are actually going to buy something, right? Whereas an email gets in at least everyone's inbox theoretically, and probably, you know, 25% of people are going to open them. Okay, that's the other thing to think about, is that just because you send someone an email doesn't mean they're going to open it, especially when you're sending an email that's like a business related email. Okay, so step one is that you're going to get people to sign up via a lead magnet, which again, you're probably going to use a pop-up on a website. All right, in fact, if you're even a YouTube channel, you might send them to a website where there is a pop-up. Okay, next, what you're going to do is that you're going to possibly segment that email list based on if you've got different kinds of customers or potential customers, but you're going to start sending emails to that email list. Okay, you got to keep the list warm. This is really, really important in email marketing, is to keep the list warm. Okay, so what that means is that you got to contact them and send them some stories, send them some information, send them some useful stuff, send them, you know, whatever it is, so that they're used to hearing from you, so that when you do, you know, try to do a sale or you try to sell them something, they don't say, oh, I don't remember signing up for this email list, spam, okay? Because they signed up 6 months earlier and you finally release your product and you're finally doing a launch and now they forget who you are and they think it's just a spam email. So you want to avoid that at all costs. So make sure that you're keeping the list warm, okay? And then finally, you're going to use that email list to sell, right? You're going to use the email list to drive traffic back to your blog, to drive traffic back to your YouTube channel. Maybe you come up with a new video, so you send it out to your email list. Maybe you come up with a new blog post, or maybe you do a weekly post, you know, email of all the posts that you've done, right? You're going to use it to sell them things. So you launch a new product, you're going to send it to your email list, okay? You write a new book, you're going to send that to your email list, and you're going to send multiple emails, and that's the core of how you're going to make money in your business. For most online businesses, especially if you're selling a product, is that you're going to get people on the email list, you're going to give them some content, and then you're going to eventually sell them something, okay? And you can reuse that, right? So the email list that I have with Simple Programmer, right, that email list, you know, I've done affiliate offers, I've sold my own products, right? I've got email sequences, they're called autoresponders, okay, in internet marketing, email marketing terms, and they have different pitches, okay, and they have different purposes, and there's a huge value in that, because you can always, you know, you can always send some kind of email to your email list, and you're always going to get some amount of response as long as you have a decent offer, and you're going to be able to generate revenue for your business, okay? So that's kind of the basics of an email list, and hopefully you can see why it's so important that you have an email list. In fact, if you're starting an online business, one of the first things you want to do, I talked about this in some of the earlier videos, is you want to get an email list going. All right, make sure, if you haven't already, that you click the subscribe button so you get all of the videos on the channel. Click the little bell, the notification bell, so you don't miss any videos. If you haven't already checked out the previous videos in the series, go check that out. I've got a playlist here with all of the videos in the series on starting an online business. And I will talk to you next time. Take care.